I think the fake news is already missing Trump. Did you see all the complaining about him not coming out in public? So my understanding is that Trump is doing a lot. I mean, he's making phone calls and stuff. He seems to be more engaged with the election stuff. But I feel like the news is already thinking, uh-oh, what are we going to talk about? If Trump doesn't come out and say something in public pretty soon, we're just going to run out of news because we might have to go look for news instead of just reporting about what the president tweeted. Former CIA Director John Brennan tells CNN's Wolf Blitzer that he's more worried than ever about Trump trying to, stage a coup or something like that, because I guess Trump is replacing some of the civilian defense people with loyalists, they say, which is making people think he's going to try to stay in office somehow with a coup or whatever. That's not going to happen. Let me say it as clearly as possible. Here's what's not going to happen: the president running a military coup to stay in office. The odds of that happening are zero. They're not, it's not like, well, there's a long shot chance. No, the odds of that are zero. And here's why. Number one, the military would never go for it. There isn't the slightest chance, in my opinion, that he could get even a loyalist to order some kind of a military coup in the United States. So it's beyond ridiculous that that could happen because the military just won't do it. And there's not the slightest indication that they would follow those kinds of orders. And there's lots of indications that they wouldn't. But there's a factor beyond that. I'm gonna make this assumption and see if you agree with it. I believe there are 20 people in the world who, if those 20 people said, it's time for Trump to concede. We've supported Trump in the past, vigorously, but now we 20 people or so see that it's over, hypothetically, it's definitely not over. But if they did, there's 20 people who could absolutely guaranteed make Trump not the president. Let me give you an example. If Sean Hannity decided that he'd seen enough information, I don't think this is going to happen. I'm just walking you through the thinking here. If Sean Hannity decided that he'd looked at all the information and said, I love the president, but I'm looking at the information, and even with a little fraud, it's not enough to change the result. The process has been served. And I think it's time for the president, my friend that I've supported, to just concede. So Sean Hannity is certainly one of the 20 or so people who, if they decided that Trump is out of office, he couldn't stay in office because he would need that 20 and the people who follow that 20, which is, the bigger force. He would need all of them on his side to have the slightest chance of working any gray areas that could keep him in office. All right, Rush Limbaugh would have to be in favor of Trump staying on, or he couldn't, right? Maybe not by himself, right? If it was an individual important person who was a rogue, you could ignore him. But there are about 20, maybe fewer. It could be 10 people in the whole United States who would, have that kind of influence or audience to do it. I don't know if I'm one of them, but I would nominate myself as who you should look for in this decision. There will be a time when, as Trump supporters, many of you are, you will have to decide. Have we seen enough? Is there no evidence? Or have we decided we're going to move on? I don't think we're there. I don't think we're there because I'm aware, not in great detail, but I'm aware that there's more to come. In other words, what you've seen so far about the credibility of the election is not the good stuff, right? I warned you early on that all of these little anecdotes you were going to see, 95% of them would be debunked. But don't let that fool you. Because confirmation bias guaranteed there would be lots of false claims. That was guaranteed. It was just part of the setup that had to happen because of the way our brains work. But no matter how many are debunked, that doesn't tell you anything about the ones you haven't seen. Once you see them, if they also get debunked, well, that's when you start saying, oh, okay, you know, maybe we've looked into it. Maybe we know everything we need to do. Here's why I submit that you should listen to my opinion. You don't have to take it, of course. But on the decision of whether it's time or not time to either support that Biden got elected, you know, at least support the outcome of the election, or to keep digging. Here's why I think you should listen to me. You know, especially those who've been watching me for a while, you know that I can turn on you, right? You know that you could have an opinion you really, really care about, and you think I'm on your side, and then you hear that opinion, and you're like, what the hell? What the hell is that? I thought you were going to agree with everything that Trump did. Nope. Nope. I've never agreed with everything Trump has done, and I tell you quite often to your distress when it happens. I'm not even a Republican, nor am I a conservative. I describe myself as left of Bernie, but better at math, so his programs don't make sense because of the math. But I like his objectives. I like to get to full healthcare availability in this country. So, you know, I like lefty stuff if they could figure out some practical way to get there, which is always where they fall apart. So here's the point. You know me to favor systems over goals. And I could promise you, and I think you could trust this, that if it ever came down to supporting an individual, let's say Trump, for example, over the integrity of the system, I will always pick the system. If I had to throw Trump under the bus, love him as I do, I like Trump. I've met him, enjoyed talking to him, think he's done a great job for the country, but I would throw him under the bus so fast if the election system indicates that makes sense, right? So I'm going to go with what makes sense. I'm going to follow the system, and I would like to have a good American system when we're done, even if, here's the important part, you ready? Even if it means Trump isn't president. I would absolutely choose the integrity of the system over any one president. All right, it's not even close. I'm not even going to weigh them as even being in the same category. The system is everything. The individual is not.